glory. And they're there in a spiritual form. And all it takes is for us to speak the word, for it to suddenly come into the form where it can be manifested in heaven. But it's all just hovering up there, waiting for one of us to speak the word of God and declare that it's going to come down to earth, and it comes down to earth. And that's the kind of understanding you'll get from this book. His revelation and you know, he mixes his revelation with science. And I just absolutely love it because it's earth meeting heaven and heaven meeting earth. So this is Aligning with Heaven. By David Herzog. Yeah. What on Earth is the Glory? By Paul Manwaring. He is on Bill Johnson's staff. And this is also a line upon line explanation of what the glory is, with the most remarkable testimonies of things that have happened in the glory realm. Some of the chapters are, What is Man? The Glory of Relationships, son, Brilliant Sons and Daughters, Restoring the Hearts of the Father to the Children, Glorious Sons, Glorious Daughters, The Glory and Government, The Glory of Freedom, Covenant and Justice. And he explains it very simply, yet he takes us into the majesty of God. It's what on earth is glory, a practical approach to a glory-filled life. Hallelujah. Amen. Whoa. Whew. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Healing Starts Now is a complete training manual by Joan Hunter. And I don't know if you know it, but Pastor Mark Bristow and Eva Dooley, they kind of grew up in the ministry with the Hunters. So they grew up with Joan. I'm talking about in the ministry, they grew up with Joan Hunter as well. And the Hunters trained them both. And then they went on to be trained by Catherine Coleman's assistant. But this book is really remarkable because it is a training manual. And not only does it train in how to minister healing, but then it goes on in the back. It's got various afflictions, various diseases, spinal disorders, muscles and bones, short arm or short leg. It tells you how to pray for it. It gives you... It is really excellent. It tells you, you know, what it may look like and what it could be caused by and why it could happen and what goes with it, what you need to look for with it. And then she gives you a prayer to pray and what curses should be broken for that particular ailment. So it's really a remarkable book. And, you know, I was listening to Joan Hunter being interviewed on Women on the Front Lines. And Jim Gold said to her, well, how do you deal with it when you don't get healing? Whoa. 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 Can you tell the people how to deal with it when they prayed for people and they don't get healed? And then they, you know, they pray for people. It's great when they get healed and we get all excited and praise God. But what? How can they deal with the issue when they don't get healed? She said, what? He said, you know, when you pray for people and they don't get healed. She said, well, that's a strange question because I have 98% healings. You need this book. Eyes of Honor by Jonathan Welton. You know, this year, everywhere I've turned, I've heard the name of Jonathan Welton. And it seems that God is just bringing him to the forefront. And I've heard of friends that are doing online mentoring by him, from him. And he has just come up and just has the most amazing Bible teachings, amazing ministry, and Eyes of Honor is about training for purity and righteousness. Whoa. And this is the story of his life. And he was addicted to pornography. And how God, he tried to get free. He went for prayer. He went for counseling. He did everything he knew to do. And he had a circle of friends that had the same problem. And they all wanted to be free. And they tried everything and they couldn't be free. Finally, he decided he had to help his friends. So he went to the Word of God, and he began to study it and get the scriptures, and he began to declare the scriptures over his friends, and they declared the scriptures over him, and all of them got set free. And he talks about his testimony here, and then he talks about the fact that, you know, temptations will come. And I just want to read to you quickly about the testimony of the conversation that took place in his heart in prayer with the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, the lie you believe is that you're tempted by sexual sin. Jonathan, yes, I am tempted by sexual sin. That doesn't mean that I want to sin, but aren't I always going to be tempted by sexual sin? Holy Spirit, did I crucify your old flesh nature on the cross in Christ? Jonathan, yes. Holy Spirit, did I make you a partaker of the divine nature? Jonathan, yes. Holy Spirit, knowing that God is never tempted by sin, what part of you is drawn after and tempted by sin? Jonathan, are you saying that I should never be tempted again? Holy Spirit, not exactly. Temptation will always come. Whoa! Oh. Oh. But because your flesh nature has been replaced by divine nature, there is nothing within you drawn towards sin. Temptation will always come, but because your flesh nature has been replaced by divine nature, there is nothing within you drawn towards sin. Jonathan, so temptation will pass in front of me, but I will not be tempted by it. Amen. Holy Spirit, exactly. Isn't that beautiful? The simple brilliance of God. A Rose for Jesus by Sadhu Sundar Selvaraj. You know, I love Sadhu Sundar Selvaraj. He is so funny. He gets caught up into the heavenlies. He spends 8 or 9 hours with the Lord every day. He has visitations in his rooms. He interacts with angels. And when he comes face to face with people, you know, he can be quite stern, actually, from the pulpit. But he also is hysterical. And so this book is all about the preparation of the bride. The bride has made herself not just ready, but rapture ready. And it's a beautiful Bible study with great revelation. And he's talking about how the bride is humble and how she's true and how she walks a walk that is so different to everybody else's. And she gives with all her heart. And his example of humility is, you know, on TV, when somebody's giving somebody a donation, they will make this huge check so that everybody can see the size of the check and you can all read the numbers on it. And he said, well, that's not what God wants us to do. God's way is you just slip it in the palm of their hand. A Rose for Jesus, Sadhu Sundar Selvaraj. Paradise, the Holy City, and the Glory of the Throne is one of my very favorite books. It's published by End Time Handmaidens. Whoa! Whoa! Sister Gwen received this manuscript, not from the Lord, from a person, in the 80s, and was out of print, and she printed it. It's by Reverend Elwood Scott, how he got caught up. God told him he was going to be caught up into the heaven for 40 days. So he got his servants and told them what was going to happen and said, stand guard out over my body because I don't want anybody burying me while I'm gone. So and you know the tabernacle is a pattern of that which is in the heavenlies. Paradise, the holy city, and the glory of the throne. And he got caught up into these three regions in heaven, and he explains who he met there and why there. And the, my most favorite thing is the great holy convocation in the glory of the throne room, which is like the holy of holies. And this great convocation, the master of ceremonies and the main speaker was the Lord Jesus Christ. It's a beautiful book that will make you long for heaven. And a book by our own Bob Baldwin, who's on our staff. This is his latest book, his newest publication, The Glories Within the Glory. And it's beautiful teaching. If you want to know about the glory, this is full of the Word of God. And he just explains every realm of glory in the Word of God. And it's a really powerful, powerful little book. So please see Bob's table and get this book from him. You will be blessed. Thank you so much.
I just have two announcements. One, I need to see a Michelle Kollig, K-O-L-L-I-G. We've got an issue with your check. And the other is that we now have a lost and found. There's a table straight back this aisle. That long table across the center, they said I put the lost and found on that table. So if anybody's missing anything, you think we picked it up and put it, it'll be put back there on the table. Thank you.
I just want to give a word of, just to remind everybody, Pastor Don asked me to share that there is children's ministry in the afternoon during the Bible study. So I think people didn't think there would be any, and there were the children did not attend. So just to encourage you to bring the children, and for the children, and the nursery is available as well. So please avail yourself of that. Let's not let the kids miss anything that God has for them at this convention. Amen. Especially our little ones, our 4 to 11? 4 to 11 years old. Let's deposit. Let's let the Holy Spirit deposit that seed that is going to grow and keep them all the way till Jesus comes. Amen. That's important. Oh, let me tell you how powerful to see this generation that is being raised up now to serve the living God. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I also want to encourage you to stop by that exit door there. Our Angletal media table is there, and the forms that you need to fill out for your entire program, CD or DVDs, is available there. Please avail yourself and don't wait to the last minute. I have a really good friend that I don't want to have to stay up all night, every night, okay? Yes. The one over here, I don't know which one it is. Registration, beg your pardon. All right, and that door over there, for those that don't realize, there's a restroom over there too. So the other thing I want to mention as well, to remind you that tomorrow at noon, you have to turn in your End Time Handmaiden and Servant applications to membership office. And that there is a required meeting tomorrow, also in the afternoon at 2:30, I believe, right? Okay, God bless you. Are you ready to worship our Lord? All right, stand up and let's give God, let's shake off those heavy bands. Come on, shake them off. Shake them off. Lift up those holy hands. Let all God's people praise the Lord. Amen. You want to do it again? Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let all God's people praise the Lord. Shake off those heavy bands. Lift up those holy hands. Let all God's people praise the Lord. Well, let's just praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let all God's people praise the Lord. Shake off those heavy bands. Lift up my holy hands. Let all God's people praise the Lord. Well, let's just praise. Logistics. Do you have the piece of music that we need next, Philip? You did.
Is it here?
Here. Okay. I've just been told I need a handheld mic because.
Can I hear okay?
Can you put my countrymen in the monitors a little bit more? Is it in there? It's in there,
yeah,
some. Yeah, it's there. Okay, so I don't need this. You know, I'm just really looking forward to heaven. Where we won't have all this technicality stuff. Everything will just work.
Amen.
It'll all be just perfect.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Well, Mary Lois prophesied that we're going to have dancing.
So no, Rona.
Oh, Rona did. Beg your pardon. Rona prophesied we're going to have dancing. So we changed the song that we're going to do next. So that you can dance. Hallelujah. Philip, do you want to lead this?
It'll be all right.
Have some guitar.
It'll be all right.
There we go.
Joel 3:16. And the Lord shall roar out of Zion, and he utters his voice out of Yerushalayim. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. His trumpet is sounding in the mountain. You have your shofars?
Shofars, anyone?
Shofars. Ooh, got your shofars. Let's have them ready. Hallelujah. Open
Please
up the heavens.
Of all of this
bring
right
thy kingdom in.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord shall roar.
The Lord shall roar out of Zion. He utters his voice out of Jerusalem. His trumpet is sounding in the mountains. Open up the heavens. Bring thy kingdom in. Day of the Lord.
going to speed it up just a little bit here.
All right, stop just a second. We'll get ourselves together.
That was just a warm-up. Now we're going to go into cut
Quintessa,
time.
Quintessa, where are you? Come on, girl.
All right. Let's do it again.
The Lord shall roar on the Zion. He utters his voice out of Jerusalem. His trumpet is sounding in the mountains. Open up the heavens, bring thy kingdom in. His banner high above the earth. His spirit is living now within us. To lead us in the battle, to bring his kingdom in. And he comes in love, and his name is over all. Sword, and he comes in love, for his name is over.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be your name, Lord. Blessed be your name, Lord. Your mighty, holy, holy name. Your name. Your name. By which the Gentiles are learning to swear.
Yes, you.
As Jehovah lives. Glory shall fill all the earth as the waters cover the sea. His glory shall fill all the earth as the waters cover the sea. And the knowledge of the glory of the Lord shall fill all the earth as the waters cover the seas. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. For the Lord Almighty reigns. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb. You are holy. Holy are you, Lord God Almighty. Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb.
Thank you.
Prophetic word. And I think we've come into that time that we need to become sensitive. There's the prophetic word that I heard went something like this. There's coming a time when you're going to be worshiping the Lamb, and people are going to be scratching their heads and saying, "What's with the Lamb? What's about the Lamb? I don't understand. I don't get it. What's with the Lamb?" And I feel like we need to become sensitive as we worship, under those of us who understand that it's in the book of Revelation that we're going to see that the Lion of the tribe of Judah shows up as the Lamb that was slain. And it's the picture of the Passover Lamb that was sacrificed at the time of the Exodus so that the blood could be put on the doorposts and the people inside could be saved from the destroyer. That was the prophetic picture from thousands and thousands of years ago, before Israel was released from their captivity in Egypt. And from that time on, God instituted the principle of sacrifice and offering a lamb as a sin offering, or offering a goat as a sin offering, offering bullocks and different kinds of sacrifices. There would be a prophetic picture of the day when he would come in the presence of his own son. And Jesus said, "I and my Father are one." He came himself as his son to offer himself as the sacrifice to pay for sins, to deliver us from eternal damnation, to deliver us from the penalty of sin, which is death, that started in the Garden of Eden. When God said, "Don't eat that fruit, it's poison. It'll kill you." But they were tempted to doubt. Maybe God's hiding something from us. Maybe we can be better if we eat this. And the sentence of death came on mankind as a result. But he came and he offered himself as a ransom. A ransom, paying the price so that we could be set free from the penalty of death. That's what the Lamb is all about. That's what the Lamb is about. And the book of Revelation says he was the Lamb slain from the foundation of the earth. That means that God knew ahead of time, before Adam and Eve even chose to eat that fruit. He was slain before the Garden of Eden, so that it would cover all time. Hallelujah. He's so worthy. He's so worthy of our praise. He's so worthy of all honor. He's so worthy of all glory. He's so worthy. Lord, we give you honor. O Lamb of God, you are glorious. You are worthy to be praised. O Lamb upon the throne. Great, mighty Lamb, who is the Lion of the tribe of Judah. son of David, the prophesied one. From the root of Jesse, one with the Father, Echad. I and the Father are one. He's the Lamb. Can we worship Him?
Thank you.
Would you do something for me? Keep the song.